Welcome to the Ed Schultz Show. It is where America comes to talk. I'm Mike Papantonio. I'm sitting in for Ed Schultz today. Remember when John Kasich and his arrogant, loudmouth Republican squatters there in Ohio's Capitol, they told all America that they didn't really care that working families and union families were upset with them about their intent to bust Ohio's employee unions. Remember when Kasich and his already has-been gaggle of Ohio Republican politicians told us that teachers and firefighters and policemen were basically lazy, they were unimportant, and that now that the Republicans were in charge, they were going to fire teachers, they were going to close schools, they were going to bust unions. Remember when Kasich told us all that? Kasich told us, he told us that people in Ohio had seen the light, and that they were all Republicans now willing to grovel around in the dirt to do Koch brothers' dirty work by dismantling Ohio employee unions, by dismantling Ohio's working middle class. They were willing to grovel around in the dirt with the Koch brothers. All of Ohio were Republicans, according to Mr. Kasich. It was going to be payback time. You remember that? It was going to be payback time to those unions who believed that it was important to actually take care of Ohio workers. Remember the rank arrogance, the loudmouth, vile language Kasich and his Republican pals used when they claimed that Amendment 5 was what Ohio wanted, because the folks in Ohio, well, they don't respect unions. They don't respect teachers. They don't respect firefighters and policemen and government workers who keep Ohio roads repaired. Remember when Kasich told us that they don't respect the people who keep their water and sewage working and the libraries stocked with library books and the transit systems working? That's what Kasich was telling you in Ohio. That's what he was telling America. According to Kasich and his Republican troll legislators, Ohio didn't respect the people who put fires out when houses were burning down. Kasich, he really believed that all of Ohio regarded policemen as lazy, overpaid public servants. And Kasich and his Republican gaggle, well, they're going to stop all that. Remember when Kasich... Remember his pompous, big mouth overloading his limited understanding of people? Remember, Mr. Kasich, when you and your creepy Herman Cain, Mitt Romney, Rick Perry-like crowd chose to abandon decency, abandon good sense, and you told us that you didn't think twice. You didn't think twice about putting even more Ohio's middle class out of work by destroying Ohio's labor movement. You told us that you were going to break the backs of Ohio's labor movement, Mr. Kasich. When you saw what happened, Mr. Kasich, it was powerfully strong rejection. It wasn't just rejection of your Fox News holdover regressive ideas. What we all saw was rejection of Tea Party Republicanism. You personally, Mr. Kasich, you were rejected. And what you stand for was rejected. What you and your Republican moral cripples stand for was rejected in Ohio. All your union-busting billionaire friends that ponied up millions to stand by him, stand by you. You know, your teabagger pals showed up to lip sync like parrots everything that the Koch brothers ordered them to say, just like you did, Mr. Kasich, just like your Republican pals did, Mr. Kasich. All that empty, blind follower kind of encouragement from all your low-level, almost inconsequential yes-men, your underachieving hangers-on. They were straight up lying to you, Mr. Kasich, about how right you were, about how brave and how smart you were to put decent people out of jobs. They told you what you wanted to hear because that's what Republicans do best. Republicans are yes men. Republicans are masters at just going along with whatever the man orders them to do and say, just like you did with the Koch brothers, just like all the Republicans in Ohio did with the Koch brothers. It was pretty – it has to be pretty scary. I mean, think about this, Mr. Kasich, today when you're trying to make sense of all this. It has to be pretty scary that the entire Republican agenda – I mean, after all, Wisconsin first, now Ohio, Occupy Wall Street, rejection in Mississippi of their crazy Republican legislation. It has to be terrifying to a political party that in Ohio, where we saw that there wasn't enough money. You understand, there wasn't even enough money available from all of those billionaires that you said were going to come to help the Republican effort in Ohio. There wasn't enough money from America's billionaires to reverse the tsunami. It is a tsunami, Mr. Kasich. You are drowning in a tsunami of popular rejection, rejecting you, rejecting the GOP teabag, old, irrelevant voice. You are drowning, Mr. Kasich. The Republican Party, the old, worn-out, irrelevant Republican Party is drowning, and you helped take them there. Get used to it, Mr. Kasich. Get used to it, Republicans. Get used to it, Tea Party. You and your Tea Party Republican group, you have a lot more problems coming your way.
This is the Ed Schultz Show.